Practice set 19, problem number 5. Compute the taper angle T. This steel shaft doesn't have that taper angle on it, but they're asking us to calculate that angle of this taper. It may seem a little odd, but the trick to computing the taper angle is to create a right triangle by squaring off the taper. So if I draw a line here, and if you remember a geometry principle, if you have parallel lines cut by a third line, we have alternate interior angles are equal. I want to find the measure of this angle here, which will be half of the taper angle that I'm looking for. Well, I have right triangle trigonometry to help me, but I need a right angle. So I'm going to bring this out only to the right end of our taper and square it off. And I could do the same thing at the bottom. I have two right triangles. I'm interested in the measure of this angle up here. We'll call that A. I know this span is 7 inches, the length of our taper. We know the overall width of the taper on the left-hand side is 2.2. On the right end, it is 1.2. The difference between those two will be this length plus this length. So to find X, I'm going to take the overall taper width, the widest measurement, 2.2, subtract the narrow from it, and then divide it by 2, since half of that distance is here and half of that difference is down here. So 2.2 minus 1.2 leaves us 1 inch. Dividing that by 2 gives us a 0.5. So half an inch here, half an inch there would combine to give us the entire width of the widest end of this shaft. Now what I have is a right triangle, and let me draw that right triangle that's at the top here outside and a little bit bigger. We have a length of this side of our right triangle is 7 inches. We just calculated that this side is 5, and what we want to know is what the measurement of that angle is in this right triangle. Labeling the sides will help us determine which trig formula to use, always starting with the side opposite the right angle, which is the hypotenuse. Through the triangle from our reference angle, we'll label the opposite, and the third side is the adjacent side. Since we're dealing with adjacent and opposite, we will use the tangent formula. Tangent of an angle is equal to the opposite side length over the adjacent side length in a right triangle. We don't know the angle measurement. The opposite is half an inch. The adjacent is 7 inches. Simplifying that fraction by taking the numerator, 0.5 divided by 7, gives us a decimal value of 0.0714. We want to have the angle measurement by itself, so to undo the tangent, we'll take the inverse or the arc tangent of our angle. To maintain equality, we also have to take the arc tangent of the right-hand side. The arctangent of tangent cancels out, leaving A, and using your calculator, arctangent often is symbolized with tangent to the negative 1, gives us a value of 4.09. We're not done, though. If you return back to the diagram, we were determining this angle here, which is equivalent to this angle. The question, though, is to find the measure of the taper angle, which means to find angle T, the taper angle, we need to double or multiply the angle that we found to come up with our value for this problem. Doubling 4.09 and rounding to the nearest tenth gives us a taper angle of 8.2 degrees.